the judges and all my fellow competitors. Remember the old quote, "The farmer works from sun to sun, but women's work is never done"? Well, it seems that not only is women's work never done, the definition of work keeps changing. When I began to consider the changing role of agriculture, women in agriculture over the last 50 years, it brought to mind Ellen McLean, the amazing woman I spoke about in this competition last year, who was inducted into the Canadian Agricultural Hall of Fame for championing the rights of women in agriculture. She told me that women in agriculture used to be called farm wives, but it seems that now they're just called farmers. That's a pretty significant change in less than 50 years. When I asked Dr. McLean why she thought there were only 4 women inductees into the Agricultural Hall of Fame, she let me know that in her opinion, many of the male inductees really should have been inducted as a couple. But the men were honored because that's the way the world worked, and that their wives were viewed as dutiful supporters, but really they were part of a team and should have been recognized as such. 50 years ago was the early 1960s, a time of unprecedented and incredibly rapid change in society. It was only a few years earlier that Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on the bus. Back then, women were seen largely as support workers to men who were often seen as being in charge, whether or not that was actually the case. It seemed that women in agriculture mirrored their counterparts in all other walks of life. It was very rare for a woman to own and operate a farm, so rare that there are no records that even reflect this. The first U.S. Census for agriculture that even accounted for gender wasn't even conducted until 1978, when less than 3% of farms were operated by women. That number has doubled in the 25 years between 1978 and 2003. Today, about 10% of all U.S. farms are operated by women. That number is lower in Canada at about 5%. It is also very common now, in a rapid increase over the last 2 decades, to find women in any number of agricultural professions. Additionally, over the past 2 decades, more women are studying agriculture than ever before. According to the 2001 Canadian Census of Agriculture, Canadian women solely operate 5% of the farms, a jump from the 4% that were solely operated by women a decade ago. Women and men working together operate 85% of all farms. Despite this slight increase, the number of women under age 35 that own and operate farms is half of what it was in 1991. The number of women farm operators 55 years and older has increased. This means that the women working on the farms are getting older without a younger group of women to take their place. In other words, the number of women entering the farm world is declining. In Canada, women are at the forefront of organic farming and are likely to run small farms with sustainable environmental practices that market their produce directly to the consumer. Perhaps the most significant area of change for women in agriculture, which also has the potential for the greatest impact on the large number of people, is in the developing world, where 43% of the agricultural workforce is made up of women. As women gain more rights in the developing world in terms of access to education, ownership of land, and to credit, especially in the form of microloans, the impact on hunger and food supply is being directly affected. Providing access to the same resources for these women is estimated to have the potential to increase the supply of food by 4% over just several years, which would be sufficient to lift between 100 and 150 million undernourished people out of the ranks of the almost 1 billion people who are now hungry. That seems amazing to me. In September, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton hosted a conversation as part of the UN General Assembly to talk about women's contributions to global food security, which underscored the need to invest in women farmers. Secretary Clinton also announced a new $5 million grant to find new and innovative ways to support women in food security and agriculture and promote gender equality. Madam Clinton has caused a stir in the past few years by always referring to farmers in the developing world as she instead of he, to reflect the role of women in farming. I was amazed to learn that as recently as the late 1970s in Canada, a farmer's wife could not be paid for the work she did on her own family's farm. She could be employed by another farmer, but not by her own husband, which meant that she could not pay into the Canada Pension Plan or be eligible for social programs that may benefit a farm wife and her children if there were times of trouble or something were to happen to her husband. This kind of unfairness and inequality have disappeared as women have moved from support roles to being on the front lines of whatever kind of work they choose to take on. Nowadays, a woman in farming is as likely to be fulfilling a more traditional role, like working as part of a family farm, maybe housekeeping, bookkeeping, and keeping everybody clean and fed, to running machinery, being in charge of operations, driving the tractor, or marketing whatever she produces. I do wonder if there's been as significant a shift in men taking over more traditional women's roles, whether it's been such an obvious shift in the opportunities available to women. Are there as many men doing laundry as women driving tractors? I think that for young women like me, it is an important reminder not to take for granted the road that was plowed before us by all women, and to make the most of what is available to us now as a matter of course. How wonderful is it that nobody, women and men, need wait a single moment before starting to improve the world? Thank you.